Hi all, my name is Tarindu Galadi. I represent the first batch of Food Science and Technology. And the society has asked me to deliver a small speech about new product development. So in this small talk, I will be covering few topics such as like how we initiate the product development process for the cycle, and what are the tools we should have with us, and what are the difficulties, and how we should change our approach when those come, and how to measure the feasibilities of the new product development. So those will be the few topics I will talk about. So first one is what is a new product development, or what should be the approach? As a food scientist, like I have seen many students within the last like maybe 12, 13, 14 years, they are doing the chef's work. So as a food technologist, we shouldn't be chefs. So the industry is expecting much more than what chef can do from us. So what the chef is doing, they just mix whatever they have and they innovate few recipes, and they use the technology they have, like they have ovens and dryers and you know, the few mixers and everything. They innovate new products from that. So from the food technologist point of view, that will not be a development. That is like you change your recipe, how you do the product and how do your recipe, and you change those things to make your recipe more tasty, or the texture looks good, more adding more aesthetic values. So that will be their approach. So our approach is to invent or make a product that is not feasible for commercial manufacturing, to make it more feasible and to do the cost reduction of some kind of a manufacturing. So that those are the main points as a food technologist we should cover. So in the first phase of product development, what we have to do is we have to identify the gap. So we should ask ourselves why we are doing this development. Without a proper gap in the market or like in the need of the industry, we shouldn't do anything. And tell you the same, you need to, before you start a development, you need to do many things before that. There are many homeworks you have to do. So first one is identify the gap. Second one will be thinking like, if I develop this, what will be the feasibility of doing that in a commercial scale? Because as a food technologist, as I told you, we are not chefs. So whatever we develop, those products should be able to commercialize. It means in the larger scale, industrial scale, that should be, the product should be able to manufacture. See, like if you take as an example, if you say avocado pulp, we can make it at home without energy and we can enjoy that particular dessert. But when it's come to commercial preparation, there are many drawbacks because of the avocados, enzymes and brownings, and because of huge amount of protein that is going to easily deteriorate. And there are many issues that we have to overcome. So main thing should be, whatever we design, it should be commercialized. And also, we should check the marketing aspect of that. How we market that. What will be the USPs of marketing that? USP means the selling points, the unique selling points that we are telling about our product. So those selling points will carry the sales for you. So other part is like, you have to always go to your customer and get their feedback. And that feedback should be good for you. And of course, those whatever the product that we are doing, those should be under the local regulatory advisors. So before you do all those things, you should be occupied with all those things, like how to do a market analysis, how to do a survey, how to get the legal aspect of whatever the product that you are going to do, and what are the gaps that is there. So all those things you can't do within a 6 month time. That's what I'm saying. Like, if you are planning to do a new product development, you have to at least devote 2.5 years for that particular product, or else you will come with a half-baked one. So when you develop the product and you check the commercial feasibility and you market that product and you get the feedback and you do the small alterations and the things that will make it more commercially feasible and more marketable. So when it's come to the feasibility, like, see, the product development is like a litmus test for all the food technologies, because if you know the food technology course, you will find we have been taught like almost all the subjects. Sometimes we wonder why they are even teaching those subjects for us. So ultimate goal of those subjects will be to make a successful entrepreneur out of that particular degree program. That's why they are teaching us economics. That's why they are teaching us marketing. That's why they are teaching us some extension program, human resources, project management, and you name it, we are getting that. And the basics for product development, like, you should have general idea of food engineering, chemistry, and microbiology, because most of the development will be touching one part or all the three parts. So you need to have that strong base to do a proper one, because you can't just develop a product. You have to propose the machineries. You have to know the values of those machineries. You have to give a project proposal for people who are interested on that. So you need to know all those things when you are starting and when you're on the product development phase. So when you do the development, like, it can be the whole new thing. It can be an innovation. It can be a development for whatever is already done. So you need to have a phase diagram, like a Gantt chart, idea of what are the steps that you will have and what step is the most important step for you. So because it is a kind of a big project, so it's better to have a project management file if you are good with Excel and all those things. So you will know what should be covered to do a better one. Of course, without all those things also you can do many things, but I'm just talking how to be successful on that. So once you have that, when you are on the job, you need to put your technical knowledge as much as possible for that particular project. Don't take the shortcut easily. So you try to do a complete job. You try to find the nutritional value or the analysis part, you find the physical properties, as I said, you find the machineries, you try to, when you present, when you say, okay, I have innovated a product, I have done a new product development, those aspects should be fulfilled with your project. So the next phase will be how you do the marketing part. So when once you have a new product, you have to do the marketing part. So, since you have studied the marketing plan and everything in the initial scale, now you have to just launch it. You have to find the target group of whatever the product development or innovation or tweaks you have done. So, you have to approach them, you have to do social media, and you have to educate people, you may have to find the expertise on that, you have to make a paper article on that. You can get a patent on that. You can publish that patent as a marketing tool. You can put in a LinkedIn, social media, websites. Even there are many website that the developments are happening, so you can put there and you can let the world know that you have done this. So the other part of this, that like to give a proper like the total solution, like if you can come up with a design for the packaging even, because we are learning packaging, not the artworks, like what is the best packaging method for my new development, where it should be packaged, what is the storage condition, what is the shelf life. So all those things should be there to be a successful development. The other part is, what are the drawbacks and difficulties you will be facing when you are doing this project? So as I said, so the major drawbacks will be like, see, when you do a development, it's always not going to take the path that you are expecting to do. So you should be able to, like, yes sir, of course, it's a scientific method, you should be ready to face the serendipity. Like serendipity means like you will see many observations that you are not expecting to observe in that particular project. You have to take those things positively, and you have to go behind people, like you have to do many, you have to put many sweat into your project. It's not easy, and you have to find people, go behind them, take their knowledge, take their assistance. You will be talking to thousands of people, like when if you are doing a customer survey earlier to your project to get to know the understanding of the project, you have to go behind the people outside of the university. You have to go to the general community, and they are not willing to give their ideas very easily. You have to go behind them, you have to get their ideas, analyze and get it statistically analyzed to make it a project data. So all those things you have to do, and you have to be ready with that, like, because it's like, as I say, it's a litmus test for all the food technologies, because you have to apply all the things you learn, like 95% of what you learn in the course plus your common sense to get a proper developed product. So, and the other few challenges will be like, once you develop your product, you have to write a paper article. You have to publish that as soon as possible. Maybe a patent, maybe a research article. Because there are people who take the shortcuts, those who will, as I said, tweak here and there of the same thing, and they will put a paper out before you, claiming that they have developed that. So don't let it to be happen, because you, if you do a good one, there's always value for that. So you make sure that you do that part also. And you keep a project proposal, which you can update always. So see, sometimes that particular development, particular small project that you do at your university life will be your jackpot, because there will be investors for that kind of a product, because there are people who are having the money that they can spare to invest. And if you have a proper proposal, they are always willing to invest if you can show the return of investment. So that's why you have to learn the economics also, where you can do your the proposal with numbers included. So if there are any person who are willing to invest, they will know, okay, this is feasible project, then I can do that. Since you know the development side, the machinery and everything, you can be a successful entity. So now I have talked almost 15 minutes, so I just, let me conclude the small description about product development, because I wanted to share, like, I know that you know the subject matter. I am just telling you the holistic view of how to approach and what you shouldn't do, what you should do, and but be innovative. you have to tell the world that we are food technologists, we are not chefs. So use engineering, use chemistry, use microbiology, use your knowledge on preservation, the sensory evaluation, and the other rest of the things. So your project will be much more successful, and would like to see many authentic, actually new developments, innovative products, innovations from the future generation. Okay, thank you everyone for listening, and wish you a happy new year. Thank you.